up in the sky. It's a bird.
It's a plane.
What is up, guys? Kid Critic is back! He is back with another review, and this review is on the new film Crawl, which is directed by Alexandra Aja and stars Kaya Scodelario, and it's about...
When a massive hurricane hits her Florida town, young Haley ignores the evacuation orders to search for her missing father, Dave. After finding him gravely injured in their family home, the two of them become trapped by the rapidly flood waters. With the storm strengthening, Haley and Dave discover an even greater threat than the rising water level, a relentless attack from a pack of gigantic alligators.
Alright, now that we got all that nonsense and gibberish out of the way, Joker, start this review for us.
And here we go.
Okay, so going into this movie, I quite liked the trailers. The trailers kind of showed me that this movie is probably going to be just some dumb fun with alligators and a tsunami, and this is going to be tons of fun. I'm like, yes, I am in! And coming out of the movie, I ended up having an absolute blast with this film. And to start off with the pros with this film was so intense. Like, I barely had any fingernails left by the end of this movie because it was just that intense. Like, as soon as the alligators come in until the end of the movie, it is just intense. Just kind of like A Quiet Place was, how it was an hour and a half and the whole thing was intense. Now, is this movie as great as A Quiet Place? No, absolutely not. I mean, A Quiet Place was my favorite movie of the year, but yes, while this movie was intense, it does not reach the level of A Quiet Place, but still, it doesn't matter if it's as good as A Quiet Place. This movie was just absolutely nail-biting. Now, when it came down to the performances, I thought the performances were solid. I thought the main girl was good. I mean, I've seen her in some stuff before. I've seen her in Pirates of the Caribbean and the Maze Runner movies, and the guy who plays her dad, I also thought was pretty solid. But however, the girl that plays her sister, even though she only has like a brief part and is not really in the movie, and you'll see it once you watch the movie, I don't know, something about her voice just didn't sit right with me. It was just like, I don't know. My other pro with this movie is that you were able to feel the stakes in this film. Like, you felt people can die and get hurt. Now, I don't know if it's because he had a dog in this movie, because, you know, I care more about dogs than humans when it comes to movies. And there was a dog in this film. Now, does he survive? I don't know. I'm not going to spoil it. But overall, I just felt the stakes in this movie because people died. People got hurt. Hopefully, it wasn't the dog. But yes, I did feel the stakes, and it just enhanced the intensity of this movie. Which then led to moments in the film where I was just like, oh my god, what just happened there? Like, out of nowhere. And it was just like, oof. It was just, again, it added to the intensity. It added to the stakes. It added to the nail biting. And it was just, wah! Now let's head into the cons of this movie, because you know, not every movie's perfect, but I mean, there's some out there that are perfect. Obviously, the Kid Critic movies are perfect, but anyways, with those aside, this movie definitely has its problems. There's moments where I was just like, I questioned the movie. I was like, so that happened, but wouldn't this happen? If that happened, I know I can't, and I'm being very vague and stuff, because I don't want to spoil anything, but it just had me question the movie. Or I was like, I think that would actually happen. And I'm like, wouldn't the alligators do that if she just did that? But anyways, yeah, that was, I know you're probably like, what the heck did he just say? But you'll see once you see the movie. I also feel like the relationship between the father and daughter, while I thought it was actually pretty decent, I felt like it could have been more fleshed out in the movie, and I could have felt more of an oomph and probably cared more about the relationship, because to be honest, I cared more about the dog than their relationship. And my last comment is kind of a little bit of a nitpick. There were moments where I felt the dialogue was a bit corny and on the nose, and I was like, well, that didn't really work for me. But overall, I had a blast with Crawl. It's an hour and a half of intensity, nail biting, gruesome, alligator fun, and it just made, and at the end of the day, just don't go to Florida during hurricane season, because or else you're going to get eaten by alligators. And it's just a fun movie experience. I definitely recommend this movie. It's better than I thought it was going to be. And with that said, guys, I'm going to give Crawl a 4 out of 5 Fernies. I had a blast with this movie. Again, performances were solid. It was intensity. I barely have any fingernails left, and I actually really enjoy this movie. It's one of my favorite movies of the summer so far. And with that said, guys, tell me down in the comment section below, what did you think of Crawl? I had a blast with it. And don't forget to like and subscribe. And as always, in every single Kid Critic video, look out for the next video or review. And peace.